Hello everyone. In previous part we have studied advantage of computer network. And now next page number 8 we have studied hardware using in networking. That means different type of hardware which is needed when we are connected to the network. That means when we are making a network, then some type of hardware resources are important. There are some physical components that are used to create a network. Let us study about them. First, computer. They are necessary to form a network. It does not matter that same type of computer are necessary to connect in a network. A network may contain different type of computers like Macintosh and PDP. The first thing is required is computer, because it is the major thing whatever we are using. Next thing is network interface card, NIC. It is device that join a cable to a computer. It is installed inside a computer. It has a part where we plug in the network cable. That means it is that part where we can connect two parts. It have software is also installed in our computer, and by cable we can connect it. Next is connector. A device that joins two computers is known as connector. By name, you can understand connector. That means connecting the several things. It is used to connecting different type of things. Next thing is cables. The wires that connect computer and their resources on the network are called the cables. Depending on the size and type of network, different kinds of cable are used. Next thing is cable. Cable is important, you are knowing. When we are connecting different type of things, cable is also used. Now we will study types of network. There are different type of computer networks. Let us study some common types that are generally used. First is LAN, that means local area network. Local area is the common type of network that connect computer and device located close to each other, such as a building. Suppose we are creating a network for a building, suppose in your school building or a company building or a hospital, there we will use the LAN, local area network. This network is used on that area. Next, personal area network, PAN. Personal area network is computer network which is used to communicate between different electronic devices such as personal computer, mobile phone, etc. A PAN is wireless connection. It is also used to connect internet. Next type is personal area network. By name you can understand, personal area network is used to communicate each other for a single person. That means it is, we can say it is personally network. We can use and we can share with in which person we want to communicate, that we can share information. And the important thing is this, the PAN is wireless connection. There is no need to wire in this connection. Next is computer area network, campus area network is the network that can be made to interconnect two or more local area network within a limited area. It is larger than their own local area. The first area I understand, local area, LAN. The wider than LAN is called the CAN, campus area network. That means it is bigger than LAN. Next is metropolitan area network. It is the collection of local area network which connect computer that are located in the same area like a town or a city. Example, local bank branches in a city. When we are connecting a metropolitan area, that means a particular city where we use the MAN, metropolitan area network. Suppose in a city, in a local area, suppose in a city we are using the network, LAN, MAN is used in a city. Suppose in a city there is a bank and there is the several branches in that city, we can connect that branches with the help of MAN, metropolitan area network. Next is wide area network. It connects local and metropolitan area network. Wide area network can be located throughout a country and even around the world. Example, internet, ATM, etc. By name, you can understand wide area network. That means there is no limit. Wide area network means to say different country or different continents network. That means whole world network. The example is internet. You are knowing internet, the global network. Now we will study network topology. What is the network topology? Topology refers to the connecting different computer in a network. Topology means different computers, those who are connecting, and in a way they are connecting, it is called the topology. The way in which the components of network are linked together is called the network topology. There are three main topologies. Bus topology. In bus topology, the components are connected to a central cable, bus, which is a single continuous cable. The data from one computer travel the length of the bus and can be received by all other computers. The bus has terminators at both the end of consumed signal, removing it from the bus. In bus technology, we can say one computer is major computer and another computer is only for receiving the data. In one computer, every data are stored and other computer are receiving. Advantage of bus topology. It is very easy to set up a bus topology. That means we can connect different type of computer to each other, and one computer every data is stored and we can share from that computer. It cost very loss. That means it is not expensive. Failure of one device does not affect the rest of the network. The main advantage of this bus topology is if one computer is failed, there is no effect on that network. That means one computer is not working, the another computer is receiving the data. Disadvantage of bus topology. There is limit on the central cable length and number of nodes that could be connected secretly is very low, because all the computer receive rest signal from the resources. Next is star topology. The star topology, each computer is connected to the switch by its oven cable. Switch forward data towards the final destination. It controls the network in communication. In star topology, there is switch, that means a main computer, and there is a switch for each and every computer. Suppose we have several computers, suppose we have 100 computers, and that computers are connected to each other. And we have a switch also, where if we want that computer is not connected, we can do it with the help of it. What is advantage? New device can be added easily without affecting rest of the network. That means if you want, if we want to add a new computer, new person, we can add it with the help of very easy. Similar components can also be removed easily. If we want to remove any computer, we can remove very easily because we have seen it is more reliable than a bus topology, because failure of one node or device does not affect the rest of network. It is more reliable, we can say, than bus topology, because if one computer is failure, then there is no effect on another. Disadvantage of star topology. The system too much depend on central device. If it fall, the whole network goes down. The main disadvantage of this computer is everything depended on the central computer. That means one computer, everything depends. And if that computer is failed, that means everything is failed. This topology is failed, we can say. Next is ring topology. In ring topology, all the nodes are connected in such a way so that each device is connected to other, one on either side. And ring topology, computer are connected in shape of a rings that automatically travel on the line only in one direction in a ring. By name you can understand ring topology. It's in this device computers are connected in the ring. You can see in your figure there is given ring topology. you can understand by the figure this type computer are connected in this device. Advantage, there is no central side computer system. There is no central. One is one main computer and connected is circle. It is more reliable in comparison to star topology. It is more reliable than previous. Disadvantage of ring topology, it require more complex control software. If one node is fall, the whole networking goes down. Similar, the disadvantage, star topology and previous topology, same disadvantage of this technology. Next point is protocol. It is very important point, protocol. Listen carefully. There are rules governing how data is transferred over network, how they are compressed and presented on a screen and so on. This set the rules are called the protocols. Rules for communication between network device is known as the network protocol. These are three main protocols. That means when we are sending any type of data, one computer to another computer, we have some address to sending that. And that address is called the protocols. The protocols are three types: Internet protocol, transmission control protocol, and hypertext transfer protocol. The first is Internet protocol, IP. It is the protocol by which data is transferred from one computer to another on the internet. On the internet, each computer has one IP address which identify the computer from one computer when user send the receive message. The message divides in the form of packets that contains both sender and receiver internet address. Internet protocol deliver the message to both on them. Internet protocol, when we are sending anything to another person, there is the address of that protocol. And if another person want to download that files or that resource, they can note that things, that address, and they can also able to download in our computer. Next is transmitter control protocol, TCP. It is the other protocol that put the packet back to the system. It is the other protocol that puts the packet back to the system. That means when the data is transmitted, it reached another computer and then it's again back in our computer. It's called the TCP, Transmission Control Protocol. Hypertext Transfer Protocol, HTTP. It is a set of rules for transferring file, image, video, etc. on the World Wide Web. If we open the web browser, it means we are using HTTP. You have seen when you are searching anything on the net, you are opening any type of website. In web browser, you have seen HTTP are given. What is it? It is an address. And where you will type the name of file, whatever you are searching. You can understand whatever you are searching, you can see when you are using your mobile phone or laptop. You can see there is given HTTP. Suppose you are using Chrome or Mozilla Firefox, you can see in search bar HTTP is written already. That is the set of rule or transmitter file where we can upload or search any type of video and images. Thank you.